A meteorological airship containing a cloud lab flew over Kennedy Space Center in Florida in September. It was carrying components of NASA's Microorganisms in the Stratosphere, or MIST, experiment. The microbes for MIST were developed at the Space Life Sciences Laboratory near the center.
MIST has two primary goals. One is to collect microorganisms in the stratosphere, and the second goal is to intentionally expose microorganisms to the stratosphere to understand how they survive.
Smith looks forward to MIST samples flying on a series of experiments over the next couple of years. Researchers, along with engineers from Kennedy's Rocket University, will start with smaller weather balloons and work their way up to stadium-sized balloons. They can carry very heavy and sophisticated payloads to high altitudes and stay aloft for long periods of time.
The relationship between MIST and Rocket University is a great collaboration, and Rocket University was founded here at Kennedy Space Center. And the idea was to get our engineers and scientists here on center more flight system experience and to get hands-on experience and to move concepts quickly through the mission lifecycle. With Rocket University, we can grab onto opportunities like their Near Space program, which is using meteorological weather balloons launched from Kennedy Space Center to achieve a variety of goals.
The second goal is the EMIST experiment, which stands for Exposure of Microorganisms in the Stratosphere. The EMIST experiment will measure the microorganisms' responses to extreme altitudes.
What it is simply to take a known quantity of microorganisms up to the stratosphere, and then once the balloon or aircraft reaches the altitude of interest, we expose those microorganisms to the environment. And then once the payload returns safely back down to the ground, we can take the experiment back into the lab and assess just how many microorganisms survived. We can also look at the genetic level and understand what type of changes happen to the cells at altitude.
From a planetary exploration standpoint, microorganisms are present on spacecraft at the time of launch. They're very low numbers because the Planetary Protection Program within NASA spends a great deal of effort to develop protocols to keep the microbial contamination on a spacecraft to very, very low levels. But it's not zero. So NASA's concerned about microorganisms simply because we do not want to contaminate the planetary bodies that we're exploring.
Sugar says microbes can survive in Earth's atmosphere if they're tolerant of ultraviolet radiation, dry, desiccated conditions, and decreasing pressure. They get into the atmosphere in several ways. Winds are the primary mechanism for lofting debris or dust particles off the surface of the ground, plant surfaces, roads, and deserts. Solar heating also causes air to rise, carrying fine particles of organic matter, dust, or microorganisms.
My background is in microbiology, plant pathology, and astrobiology. But right now, we've developed a Mars simulation chamber, which is in the background, that we are studying how bacteria that might be found on spacecraft are going to survive, potentially grow, and then, if possible, proliferate on the surface of Mars. So we're looking at microbial survival and growth under Martian conditions.
As we begin to explore the solar system outside of low Earth orbit with humans, microorganisms could be very beneficial to human activity, whether it's in the human body itself or in a plant-growing system that might be used to regenerate oxygen, water, or food for humans.
So in that case, microbes would be very beneficial to human exploration.